Hey guys, Derek here with Rated Cigar Reviews, back for another video today. I'm not in the Jeep because I sold it. Not a joke. It's gone. I couldn't afford the gas anymore, so I got a car. So no more videos and vehicles for now. But today I'm here in Rowley, Massachusetts at the Tobacco Shack on Route 1. And this is one of my favorite places to go. They have a huge selection and they have a lot of stuff to look at. Very comfortable setting. And they have a lot of good deals going on right now. And I'll talk about that at the end of the video. But today we're going to be taking a look at a cigar from Canimao Cigars. And I'd like to thank them for sending this out to me. But here is the Canimao Robusto Extra. So the Canimao Robusto Extra is a new one from Canimao, and I have smoked the original before, and it was one of my favorite boutique blends. I really did like it. It was a very full-bodied smoke, and supposedly this one is supposed to be just a hair better, and we're going to test that and see how it is today. This cigar, let me see here, it has Brazilian Arapica wrapper, and it's a 52 by 6 and an eighth. And I'm pretty sure that the filler here is Dominican and Nicaraguan. I could be mistaken. I don't have all the facts on this yet. It's a nice dark-looking wrapper. A little bumpy. Invisible seams. And a nice flared pigtail cap, which is kind of cool. So let's go ahead and get it sparked up. And one thing that I've noticed when they sent this to me, came in a really nice package. Came with two cigars wrapped in a yellow ribbon. It smelled so much like coffee that I actually thought that this might have been an infused cigar because the smell was just so strong and potent of coffee. In fact, I've actually let this rest for 3 months because that coffee scent was so strong. I didn't want that to really be the most overpowering flavor in this review. But it might be. You don't know until you spark it up, so let's go ahead and do that. It really does look like a nice cigar, though. Putting off a lot of smoke already, too. Alright, cheers.
I'd rather the fucking thing sit there and give it to those people, and in the air, I said, if you have a problem, go to mediation.
Ah, wow. All right, so far, a little peppery, medium-bodied, medium to full. It's got a nice spicy tone coating the palate. It's sweet. And there definitely is a lot of coffee coming out of this cigar right now. Little mix of coffee, chocolate, cocoa kind of taste.
Do what the fuck you want. I'm out of there. Okay, it's not going to work. You're going to create something that's worked. That's the worst ever.
Really like it so far. All right, so let's get into the first third of the Canimao Robusto Extra, and I'll be right back. Alright, back here in the first third. Ash is holding on phenomenally well, and it does look like it is about to fall, so I think I'm going to tap it, but flavor-wise, this thing is blowing my mind. Very rich, very meaty smoke, very creamy and smooth. More flavors of pepper are coming up, like black pepper and red pepper spiciness are just lingering in the back of my palate. The draw is nice and easy. It's not loose. It's not tight. It's perfect. Same as the burn. It's an extremely straight burn. Almost Drew Estate straight, which is really surprising for a small company. These are all made in Miami, Florida by a bunch of Cuban guys, so they know what they're doing. They've been doing it for a while. And so far, it's just a great smoke. Very rich flavors of cocoa, chocolate, coffee, and pepper. really, really nice. Very smooth, like I said. I'm taking a liking to this. It's putting out a lot of smoke. Definitely enjoyable. So let's go ahead, get into the second third, and I'll be back with another update. And there goes the ash. Alright guys, I'm outside of the tobacco shack now because it was getting a little bit too loud in there, so I decided to come out here. But now into the halfway of the Canimao Robusto Extra, this cigar is treating me so well. Very great flavors. It has picked up in body. It's very full bodied now. It has bloomed into this great smoke. Awesome flavors of chocolate. Still the same pepperiness, though the pepperiness has died down a little bit and has gotten a little bit more smooth. Chocolate is starting to become more of a prevalent flavor in this one here. Very nice though, it's still a great smoke, very easy draw. Just I'm really enjoying the taste of everything combined, and the wrapper is just delectable. A very sweet tobacco wrapper, excuse me. Still a nice looking burn. I haven't had to touch this up once at all. Fantastic. I'm really taking a liking to this. Ah, I figure I'll show you now. That's my new car. It's a 2012 Chevy Cruze, brand new off the showroom floor. 6-speed manual transmission. Great on gas too. Alright, well, I'm going to go ahead, get into the final third of the Canimao Robusto Extra, and I will be right back for a final update. Alright guys, finishing up on the Canimao here, and I must say it was an excellent cigar. Definitely something to try if you see it. You can go check out their website, Canimao.com or CanimaoCigars.com, and see what they're all about. See what they have to offer, because these cigars are seriously really good. Excellent burn all the way down, no problems whatsoever, no touch-ups, no relights, stayed solid the whole way through. Great draw, great complex flavors, just very tantalizing to the taste buds. I loved it, and I'm glad I have one more left. I'm gonna have to go find more after this. But anyway guys, I am all done for today, and if you're ever in the Massachusetts area, definitely come check out the Tobacco Shack, right there. They're on Route 1 in Rowley, Massachusetts, and they have a lot of good deals going on right now. If you buy a box that's over $200, you can get a Cigar lighter, which is really cool, and they have some specials on the lighters going on right now. So if you ever buy, stop in and check that out, because they're giving away some pretty cool stuff. So anyway guys, I'd like to thank you again for watching. I'd like to thank Canimao Cigars for sending this one out to me. Guys, until next time, as always, thank you again and happy smoking.